Hi everyone, this is Jane from Rockin' Worms in Loxahatchee, Florida. Thank you for joining me today. Today I'm going to be making a video regarding the red wigglers. Sometimes I make videos regarding my mealworms, but today is red wiggler day. Today is day 21 in my breeder bins, and I'm going to be resetting them. What that means is I'm going to be taking the breeders I have in here for the past 3 weeks and sending them up into new fresh bedding where they can continue to make cocoons. The cocoons that are already in here that they've made over the past 3 weeks, I'm going to allow to hatch into the bedding, okay? So when I set up a new breeder bin, one of the things I do is I mix in my worm chow into the bedding. And that allows me to have the worms feeding at all times without me having to disturb them, you know, every couple days by adding new food. But as you can see, I'm down to the last of it. So I'm gonna make a new batch of worm food. Now this time, when I make the worm food, I want to add a new ingredient. The ingredient is called azomite. And while I talk to you, I'll just continue to dig through here so you can see my lovely worms. I'm gonna add azomite. Azomite is a mineral additive. It comes from a deposit in Utah. And what azomite does is it adds micro minerals into your soil, your worm chow, whatever you're putting into. Basically, minerals from A to Z. Now, there was a 19th century German scientist who proposed a theory which has held for the past 100 plus years, that the growth of plants is determined by the presence of the mineral that is least present. So, for example, you can have all the nitrogen and potassium and phosphorus you want for your plants, but if your plants don't have enough iron or magnesium or any of a host of other minerals, your plants are going to suffer. They're going to be limited by the lack of presence of the mineral that is least already in the soil. So that's kind of hard to say, but that's what it is. So one way to get these micro minerals into your soil is to put it in your worms, your worm bedding, because then your worms start to process it. By the time you put your castings into your plants, those minerals that you've added are now more available. So one way to do that is to put the azomite into your worm feed. So this is the box. Now, I did attempt to do an unboxing video a couple minutes ago, but I kind of hit a snag, so I'm restarting over. I apologize for the pseudo unboxing, but this is the best I can do. Okay, so this is the box. I bought it from Amazon, and it is from Seed Ranch in Odessa, Florida. Okay, so that's where I bought it from and had it, you know, shipped here to Loxahatchee. So I sliced it open, and this is what is inside. A lot of brown paper, which is going to be great to shred and add to my worm bins as carbon. So that's great. Bonus prizes there. And then I have a shipping label, or a packing slip, excuse me, and a thank you card with information from the Seed Ranch. So I'm going to keep this for future information and read it for any additional information they give me. Okay. So this is what the azomite bag looks like. Like I said, it's 44 pounds and it is heavy. So what I did to help prep for this is I sliced it open so I can reach in here and grab a handful of the azomite and show it to you and me, because this is the first time I'm looking at it. So you can see that it is a fine powder and will mix very well into all the powdered goods that is in my worm chow, okay? And Azomite comes in a couple different forms, pellets being one of them for, you know, agricultural field applications, but it also comes in micronized, which is great for something like your potted plant or your home garden, or adding into your worm chow to add into your bedding, to add into your breeders so they can be as healthy and happy and productive as possible. So that's really what I wanted to show you. And I will continue to update you on how the Azomite works out in my worm chow. Obviously, you can see I'm dumping that little handful into the bedding here, which is perfectly fine. And because I'm pulling out the breeders, here's one. Look at this guy. This is a red wiggler. There he goes. This is a red wiggler breeder now covered in Azomite. And you can see the clotalum, nice big one. And then I don't know, because it's kind of a little covered here. You can see how the tail is a yellow tinge. So the bigger clotalum that's bulging and the yellow tail are sure sign characteristics of an adult red wiggler. But anyways, what I was saying is I'm pulling the breeders out. Let me see if I can get some more. Breeders out and leaving the cocoons and the bedding behind. So as the baby worms hatch out of the cocoons, I'm seeing if I can see any. It's hard for me to do this and run the camera at the same time. As the baby worms hatch out of the cocoons, they'll have immediate access to the Azomite that's in the worm chow that is being left behind, and also the adults will have access to it as well. I'm sorry, that doesn't make very much sense. Let me back up and say that when I do my cocoons, when I leave my cocoons behind in the breeder bins, which then technically become my nursery bins, I also leave behind a handful of breeder adults to keep the cocoons company. Now, what I have found is that the cocoons have a better hatching rate if there are some adults mixed in with them. I'm not sure exactly why. I hypothesize that the adults are continuing to aerate the soil and provides, you know, some type of signaling to the cocoons that, hey, this is a good place. Come hatch and join us. Another beautiful red wiggler. You can see the yellow tail. You can see the clotalum. The clotalum is a little pale on the underside of the worm. I don't know why, but it seems to be the case. So that's interesting. Anyways, quick video. I hope this gives you some information about Azomite and perhaps make you think about adding it to your worm chow or directly to your worm bins as well. And I will update you as I go along and see how the whole experiment works out. Okay, so have a great day. Please like and subscribe and comment, especially if you have any experience with Azomite yourself. And I look forward to continuing this journey with you. Yours in the dirt. Bye.